CCAA Network. Nick Rice in hand here from the Sports Center at San Marcos, California, where CSUSM women's basketball continues tonight on December 5th, a Thursday night here in Southern California. National anthem from the Sports Center coming up next. Welcome to San Marcos, California. We are live at the Sports Center for CSUSM Women's Basketball on the CCAA Network. I am Nick Rice. History is in the making for San Marcos. The Cougars are off to their best start in program history at 7-0 with wins over number 11 Minnesota State of Moorhead and former number 14 UC San Diego. Renee Jimenez, a veteran of this league, joined the Cougars in 2015, and after a slow start, the head coach is now dominating this conference. Sophomore forward Zane Sheckard and redshirt senior Kim Savio round out the Sonoma State starters as the visiting front courts. That is just the second different starting lineup this season for Seawolf head coach Rich Shaywitz. As for undefeated San Marcos, we just saw their starters introduced. Jonae Vermillion, November's CSUSM Student Athlete of the Month, will anchor the four spot of the Cougars front court, joined by junior Emma Forel. Dinah Buckner, Akayla Haxson, and Stephanie Custodio are the remaining starters for the San Marcos Cougars under the guidance of five-year head coach Renee Jimenez. Glad you're with us from the Sports Center in the home whites, San Marcos, along with the black numbers. The Seawolves of Sonoma State, who come in at 5-2 of the year, 1-1 of the conference. They're in their road dark blues with the navy trim and also the white numbers. San Marcos, their best start in program history, are 7-0. The Seawolves have won the opening tip, and Sonoma State sets up an offense to begin the game. Not only are the Cougars good on defense, They are the nation's best three-point shooting defense this year. And go figure, a three-point shot from Sophie Northern is the first points of the game. That's for Sonoma State. The Seawolves are going up against the defense that is just dominant. They're giving up a 17% clip from the three-point line this year. San Marcos, meanwhile, they have struggled shooting the ball from the three-point line, ninth in the CCAA at under 30% this year. Buckner Motors pulls up from the foul line and drills their opening field goal of the ball game. And the sophomore, former CIF Player of the Year a couple years ago at Los Osos High School, the sophomore from Rialto, California, cans the jumper. We have played a bit at our score, 3-2. Sonoma State on offense, and the long two-point corner shot from the Seawolf guard Serena Santos is off the back iron. Buckner races out the backcourt for San Marcos and deals it left to Forel, dishes the ball towards Stephanie Custodio. She then changes gears in the paint, jump pass to the slashing Forel, and the layup is good. Those type of high percent of shots is what has made her the highest, the best shooting forward in all of the CCAA. She leads the league at 59% from the floor, averaging 12-8 this year as Emma Forel. Pocket pass in the paint for Kim Savio, and she flips it in. Both teams haven't missed a shot. They're 2-for-2 to begin the game. The Northern triples the difference, and a 5-4 edge in favor of Sonoma State. Seawolves coming at 5-2. San Marcos 7-0 to start the year. Vermillion the screen. Custodio the pull-up jumper, and she missed it just a bit to the left. And Kim Savio snares the Sonoma State rebound. Seawolves in the front court led by Santos. She drills the jumper, but the basket's waved off with the Leval screen against Kim Savio. And that's a turnover against Sonoma State. The Seawolves want to improve upon the turnovers. They are giving it up about as much as they're taking it away this year. San Marcos likewise has struggled with the turnovers to start this year. Diana Buckner breaks the full court pressure and mans the point guard spot. Through 2 minutes, the score is 5-4 Seawolves. Buckner, the driving kick left to Stephanie Custodio, a floor general for the Cougars offense. She feeds the ball at the elbow to Jonae Vermillion. Shot clock at 7, Buckner finds a seam. Her 7-footer's wide left, and the ball is tapped and taken by the Seawolves. Sophie Northern, the transfer from Redwoods, gathers the rebound for Sonoma State. Ball swing right to Savio, dishes right, pull-up jumper from Keach, and she missed it out of bounds off of the Seawolves. 7:18 to go, opening quarter. 5-4 is the lead for Sonoma State. Seawolves led by three-year head coach Rich Shaywitz. He has started 3-5 through 8 games in his first 2 years, so it's been a sub-500 record through the first portion of the year for Rich Shaywitz until this season, when they are 5-2 to begin the 2019-20 campaign. Haxson gets her first dribbles of the contest with a short shot clock. Vermillion the high pick and roll. Custodio from the baseline missed the 12-footer. Emma Forel gathers the weak side rebound. Fresh 20 seconds for San Marcos. Emma Forel this year is seventh in the league at 8 boards a game, so she has been fantastic on the glass to start this season. Shot clock is getting reset here. 6:45 to go in the opening quarter. 5-4 Sonoma State. And now San Marcos will inbound with Akayla Haxson, the transfer from California Baptist. She will trigger it in from the sideline, it appears. And now they'll redo the clock. Emma Forel sends it into Vermillion, who fires at the horn and missed the three-pointer. Shot clock violation as Vermillion launches her first triple of the season. And that wasn't quite the situation she wanted to be in. 5-4 Sonoma State. Seawolves scoring just under 63 points a game. That is 10th in the CCAA among 13 teams. So that offense has struggled a majority of this year. Keach dribbles into the paint on Buckner. Her shot is blocked by the veteran. Buckner off the loose ball. She races across the San Marcos backcourt, picks up the dribble, dishes inside of Vermillion. She rolls to the rim, cut off by two defenders. Forel to Buckner. Her 7-footer is off the back iron, and the Cougars get the rebound. Jonae Vermillion over four defenders, and she floats it in on the follow. One Cougar player against four of Sonoma State, and Jonae Vermillion wins that rebounding battle as the 5'10 big out of Corona, and she lifts the Cougars in front. Through 4 minutes, our tally is 6-5 in favor of the host San Marcos Cougars. Farrell, the dribble foul against the Cougars. Her opening citation to the contest sends number 22, Chloe Eagles, into the ballgame as the Cougars field one of the few unbeaten records in the league. They are tops in the conference overall, but in league play, they join the Humboldt State Lumberjacks, the Cal Poly Pomona Broncos, the Pioneers of East Bay, along with Stanislaus State, one of only five clubs remaining with an unbeaten conference record. San Marcos, however, is 4-0. The remainder of those teams are 3-0 or 2-0. Full court pressure for Sonoma State, and Eagles dribbles into the half court. Haxson sends it right to Custodio, and the Cougars scoring just under 66 points per game. A high-flying offense settles into a half court. 5:30 to go, opening quarter. Cougars the lead 6-5. The drive from Haxson, and she loses her dribble out of bounds off the leg of the Seawolves and Sophie Northern, an excellent senior guard who has logged major minutes for Sonoma State this year. Custodio, the inbound to Haxson. She sets her feet and left the three shorts. And Shauna Jackson snares the rebound for the Seawolves. Sonoma State sets up, led up against the Cougars man-to-man. Scoop layup is short, and Vermillion missed the rebound. It's gathered by Ugochi Anudakum, and the senior from San Jose, California, flips it in halfway through the opening quarter. Her Seawolves have reclaimed the lead up 7-6. Sonoma State, the full court pressure. Dinah Buckner finds some open floor as she dribbles to the right wing against the 3-2 zone, kicks to Custodio, passes up a three. Off the pick from Vermillion, she barrels into the lane, feeds at the elbow to Eagles, and she puts it in on a 15-footer. She uses glass, and Chloe Eagles, who's scoring only 1.5 points per game this season, she buries the 15-footer. Johnson gets rid of the ball for Sonoma State. Seawolves move it around to the right side, out towards Keach. Up top to Johnson. She motors into the lane on Custodio and missed the layup. The weak side rebound to Akayla Haxson of San Marcos. The Cougars third in the league and rebound margin into the paint to Vermillion, who blows the layup. And the Seawolves force a one and done. Sonoma State, so far in this ballgame, they've gotten high percentage shots, led, of course, by Northern. Traveling violation from the senior Sophie Northern. Turnover for the Seawolves. And with 3:58 to play in the opening quarter from San Marcos, the unbeaten Cougars have a narrow home lead. 8-7, Cal State San Marcos over the Seawolves of Sonoma State. Back in a moment to the Sports Center. This is San Marcos women's basketball on the CCAA Network. Welcome back to the Sports Center here in San Marcos, California. The Cougars, unbeaten on the year, lead 5-2 Sonoma State. Our score is 8-7 in favor of CSUSM. The Cougars and the Seawolves already this game has featured five lead changes in a back-and-forth defensive affair. Both clubs shooting below their season average this year. San Marcos 43%, Sonoma State 40%. Custodio at the point guard spot, shovels the ball left to Eagles. Custodio scans the floor halfway through the shot clock. San Marcos ball, they lead 8-7. Haxson Flares it left, Custodio. She drives inside on Linden, missed the shot. Vermillion weak side rebound, and she misses the follow and couldn't grab the loose ball over Ugochi and Udicum, who's off to a flying start. It's her first game played since November 16th against Concordia Portland, and she was dearly missed over the last 2 weeks for the Seawolves. Ball swing left to Keach. In the corner to Rashine Johnson. She drives and her shot is blocked by Eagles. The senior seventh block of the year, and that's what makes the Cougars such a dominant defense, which leads the country in three-point percentage defense. They know that if they get beaten off the dribble, they have different guards and bigs that can catch those from behind. Ugochi Anudakum, she dribbles into the paint and travels. Turnover for Sonoma State on magnificent defensive effort from the veteran Jonae Vermillion, the redshirt senior out of Corona. And she has been excellent throughout her basketball playing career. She is a former junior college state champion and an MVP as a true freshman out of Mount San Antonio College. And with the Mounties, she averaged a double-double for her two-year career. Eagles dumps in the paint to Jonae Vermillion. She rolls to the rim and missed the shot but was fouled. The redshirt senior, former San Diego Sports Association star of the month in January of this year. She heads to the foul line for what has been a magnificent career now at San Marcos. For her final season with the Cougars, she's averaging a double-double now and has really flourished against NCAA competition. Two shots. And she drops in the first. San Marcos leads 9-7 with 2:48 to play in the opening quarter. She does miss the back end. Long rebound, Kylie Keach of Sonoma State. Entry pass left to Johnson. Keach then motors to her right off the pick. She barrels right of the lane, and her shot is blocked by Eagles. That's the second block in this minute by way of San Marcos. Forrester a wild layup, and she missed the shot. And Taylor Johnson of the Seawolves gathers the rebound. Rashine Johnson, a transfer from Solano. A 5-4 guard heads to her right and is cut off by way of Buckner. Bad pass is poked away and taken to the backcourt by way of Sophie Northern of the Seawolves. Keach the three. Missed the shot. Kelsey Forrester, the long rebound for the Cougars. She races to the rim. Forrester got a lot of contact but no foul as she was bumped by Keach, and the Seawolves control on a one-and-done for San Marcos. Cougars with under 2 minutes to go in the first. A fast-moving ball game to start. Our score is 9-7. Nick Rice in hand here at the Sports Center. Two of the best clubs in the conference meet here. And on the entry from Ugochi Anudakum, she loses the handle for another turnover. The senior with already three in the first quarter of this ballgame. She had 16 all season. 9-7 San Marcos. Seawolves full court pressure. And San Marcos has really held their own after that fast Seawolves start as San Marcos has scored for an answer. Buckner drives baseline, flares the ball to Vermillion. She is on the block, dribbles into the paint against Adudicum, and misses another jumper. She's off to a cold shooting first quarter as she has missed four field goals so far. 1:19 to go in the first. Our score is 9-7. Jump pass in the corner to Rashine Johnson. Her dribble cut off to the right side for Northern. Ball swing left into the hands of Johnson. That's Taylor Johnson of the Seawolves. Northern changes gears, drives inside of Vermillion and scores. In a game with five lead changes, that's our first tie of the ball game as we are locked up at nine of what has been a tough first quarter for both of these offenses. Sonoma State shooting 29%, San Marcos 36%. Ball swing left, Buckner. High right-hand dribble. She motors into the lane. Pull-up jumper, shorts. And Ugochi Anudakum snares the rebound for Sonoma State. Seawolves in transition. Rashine Johnson blows the layup. And out of three different Seawolves defenders, the rebound's taken by Chloe Eagles of San Marcos. Forrester attacks and then dumps the ball inside of the cutting Vermillion and draws the contact against Sonoma State with just 17 seconds to go in a fast-moving opening quarter. Rashine Johnson is the delinquent. It's her first personal second team foul. And Ugochi Anudakum will be spelled for the Seawolves. And now San Marcos brings back in Emma Farrell, the former school season rebound record at Hope International. And now as a 6'3 big from France, she has taken over the CCAA so far this year, averaging 12-8 and leading the league at 59% shooting. Shot clock turned off here in the first quarter. We're locked up at 9. Inbound Farrell to the left for Kelsey Forrester, and she will dribble out some of the first quarter clock. 10 seconds remaining opening quarter. Renee Jimenez, the head coach of San Marcos, calls signals. As the game clock is down to 4, Forrester dribbles right with 3, dances with 2, steps and fires at the horn, and left it short. And that is a fitting way to end the first quarter. Both of these offenses off to a sputtering start of this ballgame, as Sonoma State was 4 for 12 from the field, and San Marcos was 4 for 16. But we're locked up at 9 in what has been a tough battle between the Cougars and the Seawolves. Back in a moment, this is San Marcos women's basketball on the CCAA Network. Welcome back, Nick Rice in hand here from the CCAA Network as we're joining you live at the Sports Center after 10 minutes. Our score is 9-9 between the Sonoma State Seawolves and unbeaten San Marcos, who comes in ranked 17th in America. They are 7-0 and 3-0 out of the conference. That's first place in the CCAA standings, followed by Humboldt State, Cal Poly Pomona, East Bay, and Stanislaus State. All those teams unbeaten, but the Cougars are unbeaten overall, so they get the tiebreaker over those clubs such as the Lumberjacks and Broncos. On the cut, Farrell, she flips it in off the assist from Stephanie Custodio. The league leader in assists with 5 of those a game, dumps the ball to the slashing Farrell with the finish. Seawolves set up on a half-court offense and dump it right away to McCann, and she is blocked inside, jump ball the signal, and Sonoma State keeps possession with Shea Witz. He is animated there on the sideline as head coach of Sonoma State for the Seawolves. He joins after an 11-year stint as the assistant for Sonoma State. He took the main job in 2018. And during that time, they have 4 NCAA tournament appearances. Inside to McCann, rolls to the foul line, gets rid of it up top to Sophie Northern, who missed the 3 off the back iron. Custodio skies for the rebound. And the Seawolves commit the foul. Sonoma State with the contact from Rashine Johnson. And San Marcos gets the ball back in a game with 5 lead changes and a tie. Our score is 11-9 in favor of San Marcos. The Cougars won just 18 games last year. I say just 18. That was an incredible 18-10 campaign for Renee Jimenez, who's really turned around this Cougars program. And now in 2019, San Marcos off to a 7-0 start. 18 wins might be a bit of a disappointment for the Cougars this year, given how fast they have started and the way, in the fashion which they have dominated the teams they have played this year. Bad pass from Farrell, the turnover for San Marcos. Rashine Johnson keys the break and dishes left to Taylor Johnson. The dribble drive from McCann, she barrels into the lane and is fouled. Number 10, Stephanie Custodio, the senior out of Chino, California, commits the foul with 8:44 to go in the half. San Marcos up 11-9, but Sonoma State can tie the game to the free throw line. So the Cougars last year, they were off to a fast start, not quite as good as this, as they were 10-4 last year. And we saw in that game, in that start for the Cougars, they beat some of the best teams in the country before they lost 4 in a row, sent them back down to earth, and they were downed in the CCAA tournament. The Cougars are off to an even faster start this year. In fact, the fastest in school history at 7-0. But they battle one of the best teams in the country in Sonoma State, a club in the Seawolves that's more than capable of winning in a game like this. The ball's tipped off the miss from Custodio. She grabs the offensive rebound, flares it left, Eagles. Her three-pointer is blocked. Vermillion grabs the loose ball for the Cougars. As San Marcos has 11 to shoot, Buckner with a high right-hand dribble. She finds a seam, lobs inside Farrell. The layup is good. San Marcos also second as a team in field goal percentage out of the CCAA. They just get those high percentage looks, and Emma Farrell converts. Cougars up 13-11. To the basket goes Sophie Northern, the senior, left the layup short. Eagles races out the backcourt for San Marcos. She dumps the ball to the slashing for Million, who lays it in with the foul. And the defending San Marcos Women's Student Athlete of the Month, Jonae Vermillion, has a chance for a three-point play. And the Cougars bigs and Emma Farrell and Jonae Vermillion have sparked this rally. And Sonoma State quickly counters the early second quarter punch from the bigs as the head coach Rich Shaywitz brings back in Ugochi Anudikum, who has missed about 2 weeks of action with injuries. The former all-conference senior in Ugochi Anudikum. Last year, she had 19 rebounds in the tournament, averages 11.5 a game a year ago. This year, she's averaging 13.5 boards a game, so she'll be quite the problem on the low block. But Anudikum loses the handle here on the offensive rebound, and the officials stop the play. That's a turnover for the Seawolves. San Marcos reclaims possession up 16-11. With 7:26 to go in the half. Meanwhile, Renee Jimenez, the Cougars winning 18 games. She is a decorated coach, formerly with a Pac-10 champion in Stanford in 2004 and 2005, and also was a member of the Aztecs of San Diego State for 3 years. But this has been quite the start she has manufactured with the San Marcos Cougars. On the block, Custodio. She backs her way in, shovels right. Buckner's jumper is to the right. We've got a wedgie as the ball is just inside the elbow there with 7:02 to go in the second quarter. Meanwhile, Sonoma State, they're 5-2 this year. The Seawolves were swept by San Marcos in convincing fashion last year, but did hold their own on the road as they were just 7-8 away from Rohnert Park in the Wolves then, including a win over CSU Dominguez Hills, who was an excellent program. A 14-win program was the Toros of Dominguez Hills last season, a win for Sonoma State over them. So they are certainly a team that plays just as good on the road as they do at Rohnert Park. Custodio finds the slashing Vermillion, who fades, fires an elbow jumper, and scores. For a big such as the senior Jonae Vermillion, her ability to hit those mid-range jumpers makes her such a lethal option. She comes in averaging 13 points and 10 rebounds this year for Cal State San Marcos. Up top, Jackson. She drives inside, not Jackson, Sophie Northern, and she draws contact and a foul. That on number 13, Akayla Haxton, the transfer from California Baptist. The Cougars have scored 7 unanswered and taken an 18-11 lead with 6:37 to go in the second quarter. Sophie Northern, an 86% free throw shooter this year. The senior attempts 2, and she drills the first. As a team, Sonoma State is the league's best at free throw shooting at 77.5%. And Northern, a big reason why, she drills both. 18-13 for San Marcos, that stops the bleeding, and the 7-0 run for San Marcos for a moment in favor of the Seawolves. Left sideline, Haxton handles the ball. Up top to Stephanie Custodio. She set a school record with assists, 11 of them a year ago at San Francisco State. And she's got a couple so far in the first half. She dishes the ball on the right side to Vermillion, who dances with a short shot clock. Up by 5, the Cougars set it up. Left wing, Custodio dumps intended for Farrell. It's stolen by Ugochi Anudikum of the Seawolves. Her 9th steal of the year. Sonoma State sets up a half court led by Sophie Northern, who dribbles and fires and knocks down the three, but we've got a foul away from the ball. And a turnover for the Seawolves, Kim Savio. No, that's Ugochi and Udicum, my apologies, who commits the offensive foul. Not 24, but 42. 5:59 to go in the half, 18-13 in favor of San Marcos as the Cougars play their ninth all-time meeting against Sonoma State. Their record against these Seawolves are 6-2, including a season sweep last year. Wins by 14-18 over Sonoma State a season ago. Right wing Buckner handles the ball and kicks to Haxson. She changes gears in the paint and backs out against Keach. Shot clock at 7 for San Marcos. Left side Custodio, 4 to shoot. Custodio to the rim, pull-up jumper, left it short. Farrell goes up and is fouled on the follow with 1 second on the shot clock. And Farrell will shoot free throws. San Marcos, the second team in the conference in free throw shooting. I mean, this is just a magnificent year for both of these teams at the foul line. It shows their versatility. Farrell does miss the first, but these two teams are shooting NBA percentages at the free throw line. That's 77 and 78%. Emma Farrell. And, you know, broadcaster's jinx, she misses both. But that doesn't take away from their NBA caliber free throw shooting they've had this year, both of these teams. At both of them just a smidge under 80% so far in the season. Skip pass left to Santos, who launches a three and left it short. Offensive rebound, Savio, who flips it in on the follow. 4 unanswered points for Sonoma State, but they still does the Cougars lead midway through the second quarter. Our score is 18-15 in favor of San Marcos. Vermillion shovels the ball right, Custodio. Good ball movement yet again for Cal State San Marcos. The Cougars scoring about 66 a game. They've been held, however, to 18 today. Short shot clock again. Right wing Buckner fakes against Northern, dribbles left of the lane, goes up and scores. Does Dinah Buckner. The sophomore averaging 12 points a game. She has struggled in the first quarter, was picked up the scoring slack for San Marcos in the second. Ball swing left to Sophie Northern, the excellent veteran guard, who's averaging 7 and 2.5 this year, shooting 26% from the floor. Northern's in the corner, fakes, dribbles into a long two-point shot, and knocks it down. Does Sophie Northern of the Seawolves. 20-17 for San Marcos. Stephanie Custodio wearing finger wraps on her left hand. She calls signals with that hand coming out the backcourt. Spins to her right off the pick from Vermillion. Halfway through the shot clock for San Marcos, up 3. Entry pass inside Farrell, and she lays it in. The Seawolves were giving her some interior post, and Emma Farrell knocks it down yet again for San Marcos. The two bigs for the Cougars have taken control of the first half scoring load in this game. Farrell, the defensive presence, as she forces the miss for the Seawolves. Sonoma State, a timeout with a 5-point San Marcos lead. The Cougars 22, the Seawolves 17, with 3:41 left to go in the half. Back in a moment to the Sports Center. This is San Marcos women's basketball on the CCAA network. Welcome back, Nick Reisenhand here from the Sports Center at San Marcos. Cougars up 22-17. So San Marcos is off to their best start in program history. They are 7-0 this year. The question is, yes, they're off to another great start. Will this translate to success in the postseason? Last year, San Marcos won their tournament opener for Dominguez Hills before a 7-point loss to the 2-seeded UC San Diego Tritons, and they were out of the NCAA postseason. The Cougars this go-around appear things may be different. They have beaten the Tritons of UCSD just a few weeks ago in La Jolla, 69-63. They're 7-0. They also beat the 11th team of the country and Minnesota State of Moorhead as Vermillion misses a wide shot. So the Cougars, with the teams they have beaten this year going 7-0, it's their best start ever. This is a club that very easily, as Northern's pass is kicked out of bounds by Buckner, this is a team that looks like this year, based off of who they have beaten, look like a club capable this time to win the CCAA tournament. Certainly plenty of basketball to be played for a club in the Cougars that's enjoyed a fantastic start. Off the bounce, Serena Santos cans her first field goal of the quarter. 22-19 Cougars with under 3 minutes to go in the half. A club in the Seawolves that typically has led their league-leading scoring defense has helped keep them in games, and that's been the case so far today. Vermillion is trapped by a double team. Sophie Northern joins Kim Savio for the Seawolves on defense, and a foul is called against Sonoma State with 2:48 to go in the half. No signal as to who right now, and we'll see. That is Kim Savio, the redshirt senior, who's coming off an ACL injury, who has joined the starting lineup for the Seawolves. Of Zane Sheckard's, along with Sophie Northern, Kylie Keach, and Serena Santos. Cougars with Kayla Haxson back into the game, one of the league's best three-point shooters. She drilled her 12th triple of the season earlier in this half. Did the junior out of Sunnyvale, California. Jonae Vermillion at the line to shoot two for the Cougars. First for Jonae Vermillion, rims in. The Cougars have taken a 4-point lead late in the half. And the second is good. 24-19, the lead for San Marcos. 2:44 remains in the opening half. Kylie Keach off the dribble, fires a three, and knocks it down for Sonoma State. The Seawolves third in the conference in three-pointers at 34% this year. They have been excellent from distance in 2019, and they've got another one from Northern. And now with a 2-point lead for the Cougars, Vermillion grabs the pass inside over two defenders and commits the offensive foul as she shoves the Seawolves. Five team fouls on Sonoma State, only two on San Marcos down the stretch of this half. Sonoma State settles into a half court. Glad you're with us on the CCAA Network. Nick Rice in hand. Both of these offenses shooting better in the second quarter, but this has still been a defensive tussle in favor of the Cougars by a basket right now. Northern calls signals. The senior searching to give Sonoma State their first lead since the first quarter of this game. Haxson pokes away the pass from Northern. Jump ball the signal, and Sonoma State keeps possession with just four to shoot. The Seawolves currently 2-for-5 from distance so far in the half as a team. The three-point shooting has been excellent. Sophie Northern, who just drilled a triple, she will trigger it in from her baseline. She looks, Northern sends it in with 3 seconds to shoot. The three from Santos bounces off the back iron. Rebound Savio. Fresh 20 seconds for the Seawolves. Sonoma State is shooting 8-for-21. That's all in the first half of this game, but they still got a chance for the lead here late in the half due to their defense. A long two-point shot from Santos is short. The rebound to Kayla Haxson. 90 seconds remaining in the opening half. Forrester has checked in to provide some shooting. She is at 35% from the long line. She is quite the shooter, especially in those big moments, high-leverage situations late in game. Buxler not only misses the shot, but then commits the foul. Third team foul to reach in on the sophomore, Dinah Buckner, her first personal. 24-22, the Cougars with the lead. Sonoma State, who has gone cold down the stretch of this first half. Sophia Stantos will bring the ball in the front court, still with a chance for the Seawolves to take the lead on this basket. Pull-up jumper for the tie. She missed it. The ball is deflected. Offensive rebound from Kylie Keach. Another one for Sonoma State. Their seventh offensive rebound of the half. 24-22 Cougars. Ball swing left into the hands of Keach. Sixth in the league and scoring is Kylie Keach at 15 points a game. Up top Northern. She dances on Custodio. Motors left of the lane. She is tripped and fouled. That's with one to shoot for Sonoma State. A critical infraction against Stephanie Custodio. As the senior will now give Sonoma State another crack at it here. Buckner is spelled by Farrell. That was the last foul to give, but due to that being a shooting foul, two free throws for a tie are on the way for the Seawolves here with the Cougars up 24-22. Sophie Northern, a blistering 86% from the free throw line this year, knocks down the first. And she misses what would have been the game-tying free throw. She has played just about every minute of the first half, and now she bends on defense into her stance. The Cougars up by one. The two-timers separated by six down the stretch of this half. Vermillion slashes and misses. And Sonoma State against the cold shooting Cougars have a chance for the lead on what is the final possession potentially of the half. Sophie Northern drives into the lane against Forrester with two to go in the half. Her jumper bounces off the rim and the Seawolves find themselves down one. But that defense, which came in as the league leader in points per game allowed, it's been a magnificent effort for that defense through 20 minutes as they hold San Marcos to just 24. The Cougars lead by one through 20 minutes of this game, but both offenses, a cold shooting half through 20 minutes, certainly left points on the floor. We'll see how these two teams respond, but first, the halftime reports coming up in just 4 minutes here from the Sports Center. San Marcos 24, Sonoma State 23. We're at the half here from the Sports Center. This is CSUSM Women's Basketball on the CCAA Network.
Thank you. Because of you, CSUSM Athletics was able to raise over $65,000 on Giving Day this past Tuesday. Your generosity will directly impact our student athletes. Thank you, and go Cougars! Attention students, have you got school spirit? CSUSM Athletics is hiring Blue Crew captains. Email us at bluecrew@csusm.edu tonight if interested.
Welcome to the Sports Center here in San Marcos. At the half, the Cougars lead 24-23 over the Seawolves of Sonoma State. The visitors so far in this game have been paced by Sophie Northern, 7 points, 3 rebounds on 2-for-6 shooting. San Marcos, meanwhile, has leaned on their bigs throughout the game and throughout this season. Joni Vermillion, all of her points, but one field goal have been in the paint. She is 3-for-10 with 10 points and 4 rebounds. All of them have been on offense for San Marcos. And Emma Farrell, another efficient first half. She is the league leader in field goal percentage and is 4-for-4 in this game with 8 points and 3 rebounds, 2 of them offensively. But the numbers on the offensive end for both clubs have been far from dazzling. San Marcos, who averages 66 a game, has been held to 24. Sonoma State, who has scored 56 a game, has been held to 23. So with the Cougars clinging to a one-point lead, the defenses, both of them first and second in points, second and fourth in field goal percentage in the CCAA. It was certainly on paper look like a matchup of two great defenses. It certainly looked like it would be a ball game led by the defenses, and we haven't been disappointed so far in the first half. Cougars up 24-23. Glad you're with us. We're at the half here at the Sports Center. San Marcos by a point through 20 minutes. Team's numbers through the first half of this game, it really tells the whole story. I mean, 33% shooting for both of these clubs. Sonoma State 2-for-5 from the three-point line. San Marcos 0-for-2 on shooting those distance jumpers through 20 minutes. They don't really even take them. I mean, Joni Vermillion had to heave one up at the buzzer on an inbound with 2 seconds on the shot clock. And then the other three from Kayla Haxson, that was a designed play, but really the only designed three-pointer in this ball game so far for San Marcos. Sonoma State hasn't taken many of them, but they, just like all year, they convert a high percentage of those three-point shots. So the numbers for both offenses are far from spectacular, but the turnovers have been something to note. Sonoma State 7 giveaways. San Marcos ranked 11th in the country. They have all but 4 turnovers and only 1 for 4 of the 5 starters. So it's been a very efficient first half. Ogoji Anudakum of Sonoma State playing in her first game of the month of December. She hadn't seen the floor since November 16th against Concordia of Portland, missing 3 games in a row. She committed 4 turnovers and was quickly thrust out of the game. She had 6 rebounds and had a steal, but she was such a problem with the turnovers on offense that the Seawolves couldn't keep her on the floor. She was committing a turnover less than every 2 minutes. So that was an issue for the visitors in the first half, and that really was the difference in San Marcos having the lead. Both offenses struggled in the first half, but the turnovers for Sonoma State, that wiped out the importance of those 2 triples on the likes of Serena Santos and Kylie Keach of the Seawolves. So we learned a little bit in the first half. Sonoma State certainly capable of playing like one of the best teams in this country, because, you know, with the Cougars ranked 11th in America, they're 7-0 this year here at home, where they're unbeaten this season at the Sports Center. This makes for a tough matchup for the Seawolves, and they come out after the Cougars took an 18-11 lead, and they came storming back. They went on a 12-6 run to close out the first half. That really was an impressive end to the second quarter by way of Sonoma State. Now, with those numbers in mind, let's take a look. We're here at the half, by the way. Cougars up 24-23 over Sonoma State. Let's take a look at the standings of the CCAA as we are just beginning conference play this season. San Marcos is 7-0 overall and 3-0 out of the conference, so they have a half-game lead due to that conference record over the remainder of the teams in this conference. They are first out of 13, just a magnificent start to the year for the San Marcos Cougars. They're up a point here at the half. There are four clubs that are 2-0 in conference play. That's Humboldt State, Cal Poly Pomona, East Bay, and Stanislaus State. UC San Diego, their lone conference loss came against these Cougars in the league opener about a week and a half ago in La Jolla. They are at the sixth spot of the CCAA, and to round out the standings is Dominguez Hills, Sonoma State, Chico State, Monterey Bay, Cal State San Bernardino, San Francisco State, and also the Cal State LA Golden Eagles. So San Marcos, I'm sure, licking their chops, looking at that league slate. They've got the non-conference finale next weekend, Saturday the 14th. You can catch that action here at the Sports Center as they play host to the Eagles of 2-2 Concordia Irvine, a club playing this coming weekend. But they will come in playing just five games, San Marcos with eight. League play continues on the 19th against the Cal Poly Pomona Broncos, a club which, as we look at the league standings right now, they're at third. So San Marcos has a very tough schedule coming up and an important CCAA duel against the Cal Poly Pomona Broncos in just a bit over a week. And catch that action right here on the CCAA network. At the half, the Cougars lead 24-23 over the Sonoma State Seawolves out of the CCAA. We'll have closing thoughts of the first half of this game, along with the second half tip, when we return to the Sports Center. This is San Marcos Women's Basketball on the CCAA network. Parker in San Marcos, California. The unbeaten Cougars lead 5-2 Sonoma State. Our score is 24-23 here with two quarters complete. Well, this game has been featured two great defenses in a game with some huge implications as San Marcos has the likes of Humboldt, Cal Poly Pomona, East Bay, and Stanislaus State nipping on the heels of them leading the league as those clubs are just a half game back in the conference standings after a month of the season. Leading scorers for the visiting Seawolves, Sonoma State guard Sophie Northern joins Serena Santos with 7 and 5 points respectively. San Marcos has dominated points in the paint out of this league this year. 10 points from Jonae Vermillion with 8 of those 10 inside the paint, and all 8 points in the paint for Emma Farrell, who is 4 for 4 to start this game. Those are the leading scorers here at the Sports Center through two quarters. Glad you're with us here at San Marcos, California. CSUSM with a 24-23 lead after two quarters. We didn't really see a whole lot. Both clubs shot 33%. We had 2 total triples made for both offenses in the first half. 4 turnovers for San Marcos and 7 for Sonoma State. Those were the critical numbers which favored the Cougars through all of 20 minutes. So San Marcos with a win would improve to 8-0, continue what's already their best start in program history, a club which has beaten Sonoma State each of the last 2 meetings. 14 and 18 point wins respectively a year ago for the Cougars over Sonoma State, a club that in the Seawolves is enjoying one of their best years in over a decade. So here we go, San Marcos, a team that has certainly got firepower at offense, but are also second in the league in scoring defense and tops in the country in 3-point defense. We'll see if that unit can cover the Seawolves offense as we have ended the first half festivities and the third quarter is set to be underway. The possession is to the San Marcos Cougars. Glad you're with us. Nick Rice in hand from the Sports Center, where San Marcos ranked 11th in America. 7-0 this year. The Cougars settle into a half court to begin the second half of this game and a pivotal battle between the 7-0 Cougars and the 5-2 Sonoma State Seawolves. Custodio flares it right out towards Haxson on their first possession of the second half. Custodio calls in the Jonae Vermillion pick. Shot clock at 10. Custodio dribbles to the foul line. She motors, pull-up jumper. It bounces in and out, and Keith skies for the weak side rebound. The Seawolf guard is already one of the league's best scorers and shooters, and she grabs another rebound. She's got 3 of those so far in the ballgame. Northern on the cut. The pass was high intended for the senior guard and stolen by Vermillion. 8th giveaway of this game for the Seawolves. Custodio kicks Vermillion, who finds a seam, dumps inside Farrell. She then tries to send it out and does, but the officials wave off the pass on a turnover. I mean, we're getting no official call here, and we won't get any. So it's a ball out of bounds. That's the ruling. Sonoma State possession, Serena Santos. 5 points in the first half. The veteran guard from Vallejo, California, brings the ball out the backcourt for Sonoma State. Pocket pass right, Northern. Dumps the ball into the paint, taken by Savio, who flares it out. The 3 is short. And off the McCann miss, the rebound is to Custodio for San Marcos. The Cougars shot just 33% in that first half, 8 for 24 from the floor. And they also were out-rebounded 20-18, including 7-6 on offense throughout 20 minutes. But offense is still searching for their opening basket of the second half. 8:42 to go in the third, 24-23 Cougars. Buckner inbounds to Custodio, then rolls left towards the rim, barrels into the lane, and Buckner scores. She had a quiet first half, but the former CIF Player of the Year, a sophomore of Rialto, California, knocks down her first field goal of the second half. To the rim goes Santos, and she misses the layup. That would have cut the lead to 1. Custodio, the league leader in assists, comes out the backcourt. On the left sideline, angles to her right, off the double screen from Vernay and Vermillion. She then barrels into the lane and scores. Jonae Vermillion, albeit the team lead with 10 points, that was on 3 for 10 shooting in the first half. But she flips it in, scoring on her first try of the second half. Sonoma State down by 5, matching their largest deficit since early in the second quarter. Custodio, the contest, the corner three short by way of Santos. And San Marcos as Dinah Buckner drives and blows the layup. Buckner snares the rebound and draws a foul against Sonoma State. Kylie Keach, a senior out of Rohnert Park, the same city that Sonoma State is from. A club in the Seawolves bringing her in, Kylie Keach. She commits the foul, and Dinah Buckner will shoot two for the Cougars with 7:41 to go in this third quarter. Our score is 28-23 San Marcos. Ugochi and Udicum checks in for Sonoma State. And the first is good for the youngster, Dinah Buckner. She is a blistering 88% free throw shooter this year. Or the league's second best free throw shooting team, San Marcos. Buckner misses the back end of two, but Emma Forrell taps it in on the follow. It's the largest lead of the game for the Cougars as San Marcos begins the second half on a 7-0 run. 7:36 to go in the third. The Cougars 31, the Seawolves 23. This is San Marcos women's basketball on the CCAA network. Welcome back, Nick Resenahan here from the Sports Center in San Marcos, California. Cougars, their largest lead of the game. They jump out like gangbusters in the second half with a 31-23 lead. That defense has really sparked this club to start the third quarter. The Cougars winning the 2019 Malika Sports Tours Oahu Thanksgiving Classic. That was in their last game against Chaminade. They allowed the fewest points in any game all year, just 41 in their win over the Chaminade Silvers Wards. So this is a club that's playing their best defense of the season in the last couple weeks. And for San Marcos, that defense holding them scoreless through about 3 minutes of Sonoma State. Rolling to the rim is Savio, who scores. That'll break the scoreless drought by way of Sonoma State. But that defense has really sparked the comeback by way of the Cougars in this game of this year. Forrester drives towards the rain, dishes in the corner, taken by Buckner, rolls towards the rim against the Budico. To the left side, Forrester. Good ball movement for San Marcos. In the paint, Forrell. Backdoor cut, Buckner, who blows the layup. And then Buckner commits the reach-in foul with 6:50 to go in the third. 31-25 as Buckner commits the frustration foul. That's the first team foul on San Marcos, her second personal. 31-25, San Marcos led by a sensational defense, fuels a 6-point lead. Neither offense has shot well in this game, but it's the Cougars a bit better. The entry pass is kicked. The delivery from Serena Santos of the Seawolves, leaving Sonoma State 20 to shoot. Cougars up 31-25. Serena Santos scans and sends it into the paint to Savio. Quickly flares it out to the right. Northern the dribble drive. She hangs in the air, missed the layup. The ball bounces off three Cougars and somehow rolls into the hands of Serena Santos of Sonoma State. Left side, Northern fakes the pass and drives, then scores. And Sophie Northern has sparked this recent run for the Seawolves, scoring four unanswered. The senior cuts the Cougar lead to four on the basket from Sophie Northern. She came in scoring only seven a game this year. Forrester flares it right, Buckner. Up top, Eagles to the right wing, out towards Buckner. This year, she has yet to hit a three, going 0 for 5, so she'll pass up that triple. Sends it left with a short shot clock. With 7 to shoot, here's Haxson on the drive. Off the screen, against 2 defenders. Her pass poked away and stolen. Taken on the run by Serena Santos. She's in the front court for the Seawolves. Sonoma State scoring 4 unanswered here in the second half. 5:33 to go in the third quarter. Cougars clinging to a 31-27 lead. Entry pass to Ndudukum, who then leans in and draws a foul against San Marcos. And that was with 12 to shoot. Ugochi Ndudukum at 6'1", the big from San Jose, California, is a huge force. And that will quickly force Rene Jimenez to bring in subs and add some size in there. Stephanie Custodio at 5'11", and Joni Vermillion at 5'10". Plenty of time on the shot clock. Entry pass in Dudikum. She misses the layup. Offensive rebound for Kim Savio. And she flips it in on the follow. A cold first half from the floor. Kim Savio coming off an ACL injury. She has played well in the third quarter of this game. Custodio gets rid of it in the corner for Haxson. She left the three-pointer short. Vermillion at the elbow. She launches off the dribble and misses a 16-footer. Sophie Northern, the rebound for Sonoma State. Seawolves down by only 2. It's been a 6-0 burst by way of the road team. Keach gets rid of it right. Santos, the jump pass on the left side. The corner three is good. The Seawolves have taken the lead. Kim Savio has scored 5 unanswered. Off the timeout from Rich Shaywitz, the Seawolves have taken a 32-31 lead on an 8-0 burst. Custodio to the left finds a seam and scores on the layup. Stephanie Custodio, the senior from Chino, California, and a transfer from Shaw University, knocks down the field goal. Sonoma State ball in a back and forth game, 33-32, midway through the third quarter of this contest. Entry pass, Ugochi and Dudikum flares it out to the left, intended for Keach, poked away and taken by Santos of Sonoma State. Northern off the bounce, fires a three, and it bounces off the back iron, the rebound to Emma Forel of San Marcos. Out the backcourt, Custodio, she has plenty of room, steps into a 10-footer and left it short. The rebound to Savio of the Seawolves. Northern on the right sideline, curls off a screen, hops into the lane, missed the layup. Ndudukum the rebound, and she flips it in on the follow. Sonoma State 34, San Marcos 33. 3:25 left to go in the third. Cougars ball, Custodio in the front court. Both offenses have come alive down the stretch of the third quarter, and we've got a loose ball foul against Kim Savio, who is tied up inside against Joni Vermillion. That'll lead us to an under 5 timeouts. By San Marcos, for a moment, had a huge lead. They were up by their largest. It was 32-24 in favor of the Cougars. Since then, it's been a 10-2 run in favor of Sonoma State. Back in a moment, this is San Marcos women's basketball on the CCAA Network. Welcome back. We're live here at the Sports Center in San Marcos. It's the Cougars down by 1, sparked by a 10-2 rally by Sonoma State. 3:17 to go in the third. Sonoma State 34 and Cal State San Marcos 33. Kim Savio has had a career performance for the visitors. She came in averaging 4.5 and 4.5 But in this game, she is perfect from the floor with 11 points and 5 rebounds and just hit her third triple of the year. San Marcos ball late in the shot clock against Savio and the Seawolves. 10 to shoot for San Marcos, down by 1. High right-hand dribble for Buckner. Off the screen, dumps the ball inside of Farrell, and she blows the layup. She had hit her first 5 field goals of the game. She is still the league's best field goal shooter, but she missed the point-blank try, which would have given San Marcos the lead. Santos, the senior, dishes the ball inside. The dribble drive from McCann, missed it, but was fouled. And she'll head to the foul line with 2:44 to go in the third. San Marcos, after this tilt, will wait a week before they battle the Eagles of Concordia Irvine in their non-conference finale. That'll be a home game. You can catch the entirety of that broadcast here on the CCAA network. Seawolves lead 35-33. Meanwhile, Sonoma State this coming weekend hits the road to battle the Toros of Cal State Dominguez Hills. Tip-off of that clash is Saturday, December 7th, tip-off at 1 p.m. San Marcos ball off the 2 free throws. Cougars down 36-33 late in the third. This club in the game is just 0-for-2 from the 3-point line. They rarely take threes. Pull-up jumper Buckner, she missed it, and the ball bounces into the hands of Eagles. Fresh shot clock as she shovels to the point guard, Stephanie Custodio. She handles the ball to her right and dumps inside of Farrell, who loses it over 2 defenders, but she is fouled with 10 seconds on the timer. Emma Farrell has been a force all year for San Marcos. The league leader in field goal percentage is the veteran from France, averaging 12-8 this year, is the junior Emma Farrell. Custodio will inbound and sends it in right wing to Haxson. Man-to-man defense for the Seawolves. The ball is poked in the air, and Custodio chases to keep the shot clock going for San Marcos. Custodio handles 8 seconds to shoot for the senior. She then drives, throws backdoor to the slashing Buckner, and missed the layup, but was fouled by Santos. And now she'll get a chance for one of the best free throw shooters in this conference and in the country. This year at 88%, she'll get a chance to cut into the lead against Sonoma State. The Seawolves' Kim Savio, who is having a career performance, wearing that brace on her right knee. She's coming off a torn ACL to that knee. She checks back into the game for Sonoma State. And now Joni Vermillion is on the floor, replacing Chloe Eagles for Cal State San Marcos. Thrilling game, but not the type that many would love. It's defense and turnovers and rebounding that has kept these two clubs alive. Buckner could not get the roll on her first of 2 from the foul line. She has missed 2 in a row, coming in at 88% this year's Dinah Buckner. And she misses yet again. Long ball is tipped from Farrell and taken by Newcomb of Sonoma State. The Cougars, a tough night on the offensive end of this game as they come in at 7-0. Keach to Santos, drives right of the lane on Custodio, misses the layup, good contest from the senior, then Farrell is fouled, and Gucci Anudicum providing the contest for Emma Farrell. Sonoma State, albeit a 36-33 lead, they're now in the penalty with 1:41 to go in the third. And Emma Farrell will head to the foul line. She is at 50% from the charity stripe this year. What a game we've witnessed between two excellent teams. On the defensive end, our score is 36-33. First free throw good from Farrell. And she knocks down the second as well. In the game, San Marcos is shooting 33%, Sonoma State 35%. Seawolves lead by 1 with under 2 minutes to go in the third. Serena Santos, the veteran from Vallejo, California, dishes right to Savio, flares it left out to Keach. She attacks inside past Buckner and scores. She beats the youngster Dinah Buckner off the dribble and lays it in for Sonoma State. Seawolves lead 38-35. Stephanie Custodio out the backcourt in what has been a tough night. They look to find a spark on offense. She feeds foul line to Vermillion. To the right side, Buckner. Bad pass, stolen away by Savio. Sonoma State saw that coming. Seawolves in transition with a minute to go in the third. Santos dumps the ball inside and Dudekum. She spins and left the layup short. Good contest from Joni Vermillion without fouling. Entry pass to the slashing of Kayla Haxson. She then puts the ball on the floor as San Marcos looks to cut into that three-point Seawolf lead. San Marcos hasn't trailed in the fourth quarter since their thrilling win over Biola earlier this season. That was back about five games ago. Vermillion draws the blocking foul with 37.8 to go in the third. And it's back to the foul line. The redshirt seniors at 72% this year. But the Cougars are having a tough night of the foul line today. They are 6 for 12. They came in at 77%. Redshirt senior with two free throws. The defending student athlete of the month. And she knocks it down. 38-36, Seawolves by two. Vermillion missed the second. And a whistle goes on San Marcos, the ball out of bounds off the Cougars. Sonoma State has had a losing season every year for the past decade. But with a win, the Seawolves would be 6-2. They began last year 3-5, and the year before that 3-5. So through eight games, they have their best start in over 10 years, and this would be as big a win as they've had in maybe the entire decade as they lead number 11, San Marcos. Our score is 38-36. Layup good from Kylie Keach, one of the top scorers in the league, knocks down another third quarter field goal. Shot clock turned off, San Marcos is down by four. Custodio calls signals with 9 seconds to go in the third quarter. Angles to her left. Farrell calls for it. Swings it right. Haxson kicks it to the left. On the drive, Forrester. She drives to the rim and missed the layup. Third quarter is over. And with 10 minutes to go, it's Sonoma State up by four. Seawolves with their largest lead of the game, 40-36. The road team 10 minutes away from an impressive road win over the San Marcos Cougars, who come in 11th in the country. What a performance we have seen for them. This is San Marcos women's basketball on the CCAA network. Welcome back, Nick Reisenhan here from the CCAA Network. Through 30 minutes, Sonoma State leads 40-36. Seawolf head coach Rich Shaywitz is trying to bring this program back to the heights that they had under Mark Rigby back in the late 90s and early 2000s. They were one of the best women's basketball programs in America. They had four 20-win seasons over a decade span. But after 2008, they went from one of the best teams in America. So with Mark Rigby gone, they were consistently one of the worst with losing seasons 10 years in a row. But now in 2019, Sonoma State's off to a 5-2 start and leads number 11 San Marcos. It's the Seawolves 40. Traveling violation for Ogochi and Dudekum. It's another turnover for the senior. The transfer from Concordia Irvine is keeping San Marcos in the game. She came in as a force, averaging 15.5 and 13.5, so she is one who certainly is capable of taking over this game. But the Cougars themselves are more than capable of coming back. They've had a couple fourth quarter comebacks this season. The Cougars are unbeaten, 1-0 in one possession games this year. That was a victory in comeback fashion over the Eagles of Biola this year. Custodio motors into the lane. Her pull-up jumper is good. When she dribbles inside the foul line, she is a dangerous mid-range shooter, the senior at 43% from the field this year. Santos out the backcourt. Dishes right to Savio. Into the paint to Agodio. She then powers her way into the paint and scores. Joni Vermillion has tried her best to slow down the senior, but she flips it in for another big fourth quarter shot for the veteran. 42-38 Sonoma State, and she has led the way so far for the visitors. Custodio with a short shot clock. She motors left against the triple team, shovels the ball to the slashing Forel. Vermillion then travels with three on the shot clock. And Chloe Eagles will check back into the game and spells Emma Forel to add some shooting for San Marcos. Cougars down four and the Sea Wolves get the ball back. Ugochi and Dudikum has really been a powerful force there on the interior. 6 points, 10 rebounds, three of them on offense. If it weren't for her five turnovers in this game, her offense would be just too much to overcome so far for San Marcos. Cougars down by four. They'll settle into a man-to-man. Keach off the bounce. Adudikum the ball. Right side Northern. She fakes, dumps inside Adudikum. She spins in the semicircle, fades, and scores. For an answer for the transfer from Concordia Irvine, Ugochi Adudikum. She's 1 point away from a double-double. She is averaging 15 and 13 this year. Custodio left sideline. Pocket pass to the slashing Vermillion. Jump pass right. Eagle sets her feet. Left the corner three short. Long rebound chase to Adudikum. The San Marcos offense is suffering one of their coldest nights of the season. Just 30%. The steal from Akayla Haxson. She then drives into the paint, and Haxson's floater is good. The transfer from California Baptist. It's a four-point game with under 8 minutes left to go in the fourth quarter. 48-40 is the lead for Sonoma State. Seawolves likewise have had a tough night from the floor, especially led by the likes of Kylie Keach. She drives and misses the layup. The rebound, however, is gathered by Savio. She missed the follow. Then it's Keach who was blocked on the third straight try for Sonoma State. Custodio, the entry pass, and Buckner's layup is good. For an answer led by the San Marcos backcourts. 42-44 with 7:05 left to go in the ball game. We're set for a thrilling finish here from the Sports Center in San Marcos as the Cougars, their best start in program history, is on the line here against the club and the Seawolves, enjoying their best starts in about a decade. Sophie Northern fires a three off the bounce and missed this. The ball bounces to a Dudikum of Sonoma State. And now Kelsey Forrester set to check in. Northern motors inside on Haxson and lays it in. Strong finish for the senior Sophie Northern. And with a timeout called, Sonoma State's lead has ballooned to four. 6:33 left to go in the fourth of what has been a thrilling basketball game here from the Sports Center. The Seawolves set to win their sixth game of the year, but San Marcos is down only a couple buckets with just over 6 minutes to go. This is San Marcos women's basketball on the CCAA network. Welcome back. This is the CCAA Network. Nick Rice on hand with 6:33 left to go in the ballgame. Our tally is 46-42 Sonoma State. Well, the Seawolves are the best scoring offense in the league, also tops in the CCAA at Sonoma State in rebounding. So they are a team that defensively can really take over a game, and we've seen it so far. San Marcos, every shot seems to be contested. The Cougars, 36% from the floor. They're 0-for-4 from the long line, and that seems to have translated to their inability to hit free throws. When you see the shot not going down from the floor, The free throws usually take a hit. They're 8 for 15 from the charity stripe in this game. We'll see if the Cougars can find some sort of offense. Screen from Vermillion. Buckner drives and draws an Orochi Arurakam foul. That's with 6:16 left to go in the fourth quarter. 46-42, the lead for Sonoma State. Custodio, Vermillion, Forrester, Buckner, and Eagles are the five out there for San Marcos. Vermillion finds Kelsey Forrester, the former scoring champion at Davis Senior High School in the Bay Area. Forrell foul to the floor on the Forrester pass. That's on that time number. It's on Sonoma State. Kim Savio will check into the game for the Seawolves. Buckner the inbound to Forrester. In the corner, Buckner. She rolls off the screen from Farrell, but the Seawolves quickly gather what was the fast break defense for them. Up top, Forrester. Off another screen on the short shot clock. She slashes inside, kicks to Buckner. She fakes. Shot clock at four. Forrester heads to her right. Gets rid of it to Buckner. Shot clock violation. 46-42 is the lead with 5:49 to go. Sonoma State, this season, they have yet to play in a one-possession game. The Seawolves at 5-2, they have had some impressive victories over the course of a successful seven-game campaign for head coach Rich Shaywitz so far in 2019. And with a win, they would now, having knocked off the best team of the conference in San Marcos, one of the best teams in America as well, this would be a win that puts them just a half game back of the Cougars and just a game back of first place in this conference through a month this evening. Adudicum spins inside of Farrell and scores. She is shooting a blistering 56% from the field this season and has been a force throughout this game. Custodio in the front court, San Marcos with their largest deficit down 48-42. Their offense has just been lethargic so far today, and that has been a rarity for them. Vermillion to the basket, her shot is blocked by Dudekin. And she is just in all phases of this game, has just been the best player on the floor. To the basket goes Rashane Johnson. She missed it. Excellent rebound from Custodio, sends it ahead to Haxson. She dribbles to the wing, changes gears in the paint, dumps inside Vermillion. Layup is good, and a foul. They haven't hit a three tonight, but Joni Vermillion wants to convert it the old-fashioned way. 48-44 with a chance for a three-point play for the senior. Shauna Jackson, a sophomore playing all of 11 minutes this season for Sonoma State, checks into the game to replace Ogochi Anudicum. 4:43 left to go, Joni Vermillion. And she drains it. It's a three-point play for the Cougars. And replacing Carly Keach in this critical juncture is Sophie Northern. Keach, one of the best offensive players in the league. And she is out for Sonoma State. The Seawolves are the best scoring defense of the conference. So the San Marcos offense has been tough to come by in this ball game. But Vermillion scores a basket with a foul at an important time. Johnson driving kick, bad pass, turnover for Sonoma State. And now San Marcos can call back to tie the game with a three. With 4:27 to go, the Cougars, they led for almost the entire first half, but has trailed for almost the entire second half, and they find themselves down by three, albeit the three-point play from Vermillion to get this crowd back into it here from the Sports Center. Stephanie Custodio, the league leader in assists, finds the cutting Haxson. Her floater is no good. As she was hit from behind, the ball rolls. Emma Farrell hits the floor. And now a timeout is called after Farrell quickly gathers the offensive rebound. 4:06 to go in the game. Renee Jimenez, a very important stop clock for her Cougars. It's a three-point lead for Sonoma State, but the Cougars have 27 to shoot when we return. This is CSUSM Women's Basketball on the CCAA Network. Welcome back here to the Sports Center in San Marcos, California. Our score is 48-45, the lead for the Seawolves with just over 4 minutes left to go in the game. San Marcos is coming off a tough defensive slugfest at the Malika Sports Tours Oahu Thanksgiving Classic. That was on the 29th in Hawaii. They won the game, albeit a defensive effort, 58-41. The Cougars victorious, hitting only two threes in the ball game. So their offense didn't really have much production in the game, but they still managed an excellent performance on the defensive end in the win. We'll see if they can mount the comeback on defense here. Custodio over three defenders, missed the shot, but was fouled by Savio with 3:56 to play. A huge free throw try is coming up for Stephanie Custodio. The senior is 20th in America in free throws at 95% to lead the league. But the Cougars throughout the game have struggled from the foul line at just over 50%, one of their worst efforts of the year. And she knocks down the first. Important free throws coming up for the Cougars. It seems every point has come at a premium in this defensive slugfest. And at 95%, she's about as automatic as he gets. She drills both of them. It's a one-point game. The Cougars have scored five straight. And now that defense, which has been magnificent tonight, searches for another stand. Ball poked away, nearly stolen. San Marcos with 13 takeaways for the ball game. And that has been integral, scoring those points off of turnovers, largely in the paint. Inbound is to Serena Santos. Seawolves struggling all year on offense, scoring 62 a game. They'll set up a half court led by Sophie Northern. High right-hand dribble against Eagles. Angles to her left, changes gears in the paint. Spins inside, Northern the shot. Missed it short, out of bounds. And that is off of the Seawolves. San Marcos has a chance to take the lead with 3:28 left to go in the game. For the second game in a row, they have allowed the fewest points of San Marcos in games this year. 41 to Chaminade, only 48 in this game to the Seawolves as of now. And now we'll see if that offense can pick up the slack they have left most of the year. Entry pass to Farrell, out of bounds, it's a turnover. Not most of the year, most of this game. All right, that defense for the Seawolves has turned in quite the performance. Every basket has been hard to come by for San Marcos. In the half court is Serena Santos. Most of these offenses have had to settle for half court situations throughout the night. Keach feeds. Foul line, spinning as Aduna comes. She then motors inside on Farrell, missed the shot, grabs a rebound, and lays it in on the follow. What a performance today for the senior, Ugochi Aduna. She has just been a force, especially in the second half. 12 points, 12 rebounds. Her Seawolves are up by three. Custodio backs it out. Halfway through the shot clock for the San Marcos offense. She angles to her left on Adudicum. Flares it right. Here is Buckner. Jump pass inside. Vermillion turns. Goes up and is blocked by Adudicum. Jump ball the signal. And the possession arrow remains with the Cougars. But they have just three to shoot. They're down by only three with 2:27 to go. Custodio, Haxson, Vermillion, Forel, and Buckner are on the floor. Custodio will inbound from under her basket. The Seawolves' defense has been magical throughout the night. Custodio scans the floor. She looks and sends it to Haxson. She looks. She drives. Throws up a prayer. Missed the shot. That's a violation again against San Marcos. Boy, that defense has really given Cougars the type of fits they haven't seen in the game all year. This could be quite the learning lesson for San Marcos, even if they win the game, to figuring out offensive sets to get some easier looks for some of these shooters. 2:10 left to go in the game. Santos the ball, it's the Seawolves up by a field goal. Northern dumps the ball to Ugochi Adudicum. She spins, bad pass, but it somehow floats into the hands of Keach. Left side taken by Santos. She then travels on an up and down. That's a turnover for Sonoma State. What a game we have witnessed. And it's not the fashion you're accustomed to. defense, turnovers, rebounding, the fundamentals. 1:54 to play. San Marcos has yet to hit a three-point shot tonight. They're 0 for 4 in the ballgame. The feed foul line is to Brillman. She fakes a three and heads to her left. Shovels the ball to the cutting Haxton. She finds his team on a double team. Left side for Million. Foul line Buckner. Her pull-up jumper is good. And with five unanswered, San Marcos is in desperate need of a stop. Sonoma State, they have committed 15 turnovers in the game, but that offense is shooting 40%. So we'll see if the Seawolves can convert this effort into points. 1:27 to go and a thriller from the Sports Center. Sonoma State with the ball up 50-49. This is San Marcos women's basketball on the CCAA network. Welcome back to the CCAA Network. Nick Rice in hand. 1:27 left to go in a one-point basketball game. All right, the Sonoma State defense has been heralded all year. They are the league's best in points per game allowed. But San Marcos is pretty good, too. They're second to that category and lead the country in three-point percentage allowed. Those the Cougars. And that defense may just need one or two more stops to give them a chance here late in this game. Sophie Santos off the timeout. Serena Santos handles the ball in the front court for the Seawolves. The two timers are separated by minutes. Into the paint, Aduda comes. She motors, shoots, and misses the shot as it rolls out. Emma Forrell the rebound. San Marcos down one with just over a minute to play. The Cougars, their lowest scoring game was against San Francisco State at 55. They've got only 49. Buckner, the turnover. And now there are three different players for the loose ball. The possession arrow is to the Seawolves. San Marcos rarely turns over the ball, yet the Cougars in a chance to take the lead. Dinah Buckner loses the handle of her dribble. They don't get a shot off. And now with full court pressure for San Marcos, the Cougars have maybe one or two more possessions trying to slow down Ugochi Odudakum and that Seawolves offense. 10 seconds to get it over. Sonoma State now has seven. Santos dribbles with Custodio all over her at the timeline. She gets past the logo and sets things up for the Seawolves. On the road, they lead 50-49. The Seawolves 3-1 on the road this year. What a performance in their visit to the Sports Center. Short shot clock, just 7 seconds for Santos. Pocket pass up top, Savio dumps the ball to Adunacum. Her layup is good. Timeout called with Renee Jimenez stopping the clock with 28.5 seconds left to go in the game. And the Seawolves lead 52-49, 28.5 to play. San Marcos, it appears, unless they can get a quick two-point shot, that they'll have to attempt a three in this situation in hopes of tying the game. All right, the Cougars throughout the night, in watching this, the biggest takeaway from me is, I mean, out of timeouts is one thing, but just overall, San Marcos throughout the game, I mean, it's a huge test. They can go to the film. They've got nine days before their non-conference finale against the Concordia Irvine Eagles. But San Marcos tested for the first time this year. In large part, that has to do with the Cougars in this game. Every shot, there's a hand or two in the face of some of these shooters. Now, part of that is the Cougars like to clog the lane and like to shoot those interior shots with their bigs of Emma Forrell and Joni Vermillion. But when that stuff isn't working, as the Seawolves have the size to counter that as being the league's best scoring defense, San Marcos throughout this game, it's been a night where every shot has been contested. We'll see if they can get one up here down the stretch of regulation. 28.5 to go, 52-49, the lead for Sonoma State. Custodial will inbound. Rich Shaywitz calls signals and brings in the coverage. They'll run a press, well, the Seawolves defense. Custodio sends it in, out towards Kelsey Forrester. She is an excellent sharpshooter. She fades, fires a long two, missed the back iron, rebound to Keach, and she is fouled. San Marcos, that offense, foul to give. That offense dealt a huge test today. And now with 20.7 seconds left to go in this ball game, the Cougars, unless they can get a takeaway here, they will be forced to come back down most likely two possessions here in the second half. There's a foul against Custodio. The Cougars have one more to give. 52-49. Third personal, third team foul, Stephanie Custodio, the senior from Chino, California. Haxson nearly got the steal. And a foul is called with 16.3 seconds left to go in the fourth quarter. No more fouls to give. Second personal, fourth team foul on Kelsey Forrester, the sophomore from Davis, California. Santos inbounds, and a foul is called. And that is the foul that will send the Seawolves. No, they've got one more. Scoreboard's wrong by a foul. Santos will inbound with 15.4. That's the problem with not fouling. Now foul is called with 13 seconds. Sophie Northern, the Redwoods transfer, is converting 86% of her attempts at the stripe into points. Ngochi Adudukum is set to check back in. She has just been an absolute monster in this game. And the player of the game, most certainly for the visiting Sonoma State Seawolves. Northern has two shots. The league's best free throw shooting team is 7-for-8 tonight from the stripe. And Northern misses the front end of two. Maybe I should say that a bit more often. Broadcaster's jinx. Crowd on his feet with 13.1 to go. Northern drains the second. Timeout, Renee Jimenez. Back in a moment to the Sports Center. Cougars down four. They'll need a big shot here in a hurry as Sonoma State fields its 53-49 lead. This is CSUSM women's basketball on the CCAA network. Welcome back to the Sports Center, where San Marcos is down by four with 13.1 to play here in regulation. Here we go. Custodio, the inbound to Haxson. Left side, she launches a three. Missed it back iron. Weak side rebound is taken by Sonoma State. The foul is called against Buckner of the Cougars. That'll send Kim Savio to the line. The game isn't over quite yet, but San Marcos may have just missed their best shot to get back into the game as Haxson, one of the best three-point shooters in the league at 31%. She misses what was a tough look, but certainly she got the shot off. Kim Savio, 4-for-4 this year at the charity stripe. And she drops that one in, 6.9 to play. Seawolves are up by two possessions. Incredible performance for the visitors in this game. And she continues her perfect streak. And Savio will be checked out. Shecker is on the floor for the Seawolves, Sonoma State 55, San Marcos 49. All right, certainly no shame of the way throughout this game of this season for San Marcos, the way they have performed as they come in at 7-0, their best start in program history. These fans here at the Sports Center may be a bit spoiled about just how great this team has been this year, outscoring their opponents by 11. But they were really dealt a tough test, the best scoring defense in the league. No defense in this conference will be as good statistically as Sonoma State. So that is a good thing for the Cougars. They are the next best defense. And throughout the rest of the season, including Concordia Irvine, they won't play defenses quite this good. And that defense for Sonoma State has put on a clinic. Haxson inbounds to Custodio, then throws it away. It's a turnover on the Cougars with 4.7 to go. They will implore full court pressure, but this game is just about over. Santos the inbound, no foul. This game is complete. Sonoma State delivers the first loss of the year for Cal State San Marcos. The Seawolves are celebrating on the floor as the Cougars drop the 7-1. The Sonoma State Seawolves victorious, holding San Marcos to a season low, 49 points. The Seawolves only average 56, but this is a club in this game that just, they didn't shut down the two bigs for San Marcos, Emma Farrell and Joni Vermillion, but they slowed them enough to force San Marcos to hit perimeter shots. And this was a night where the Cougars just couldn't seem to manufacture much on offense. They held a 31-24 lead to San Marcos midway through the third quarter. Yet since that moment, the Cougars shot a paltry 20%. It was a game in which San Marcos just couldn't get any of their shots to fall. But they still are, is the Cougars, 7-1 this year. They are tied for a top five spot in the CCAA standings, and we'll see how they fare the rest of the year. Meanwhile, Sonoma State, the Seawolves with a win, are now 6-2, 2-1 in league play, and a club that's enjoying their best start in over a decade, trying to renew the memories of Mark Rigby and the club that had 20 win seasons four times in a decade span for Sonoma State in the early 2000s. That'll do it for our coverage of the women's game. The men will tip off in 20 minutes, will San Marcos, as they are set to battle Sonoma State. The tip-off is slated for shortly after 7:30 p.m. Pacific, as Sonoma State wins the front end of the doubleheader tonight. Sonoma State 55, San Marcos 49. For Nick Rice and the rest of our broadcast crew, that'll do it for coverage of the women. The men tip-off shortly. That has been a presentation of CSUSM Women's Basketball on the CCAA Network.